I was picking up stuff, like little dishes, and just thinking about how cute those dishes would be in my kitchen. And then I thought they were probably really cute in somebody else's kitchen before they were in a fucking gutter somewhere. These people have nothing, and it's as far as the eye can see. This stretches down the coastline of Japan in both directions. It's pretty profound. On the last day of our Asian tour, and we're having our show here in Tokyo, Japan. This trip has been eye-opening and fascinating, and I can't wait to come back already. So we're gonna do a show tonight and a little bit of promo stuff tomorrow, and then we head up into Ofunato, and we start our volunteer work with hands.org to try to help in the efforts to bring a little relief to the area devastated by the tsunami.
いらっしゃいませ。ありがとうございます。いらっしゃいませ。こちらでありがとうございます。
I love Sara.
So excited.
I'm looking forward to your concert.
Me too.
Bye, friend.
Arigato gozaimasu. And onegashimasu. And biru. And ruti biru.
For such a warm welcome. We are so lucky to be here. Please know how grateful we are that you're here at all. So thank you.
So this is the last bit of work we're doing. And we're kind of running around doing interviews and promo today. So now we're at the radio station. We're gonna do an interview in a bit. And I'm gonna take my shoes off. It's apparently very monumental for me.
So have you been to Japan a first time?
This is my first time.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's amazing. Yeah.
Please come to our studio. Yay.
Sarah Bareilles and Uncharted on Global Satellites on a Wednesday afternoon. Great weather and a great way to spend our Wednesday. And a very good afternoon to Sarah Bareilles.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm doing very well.
Welcome to the InterFM studios.
Thank you so much.
Your first time to Japan?
Yes, it's been incredible, and I don't want to leave. We felt so welcomed from moment one, and it's just been absolutely amazing. So, and then the food on top of that,
yeah.
And the beer, and the cities, and the nightlife, and the fashion. I mean, the whole thing. I'm into it.
Great. Firstly, I want to say thanks to you for coming. You know, quite a few artists have recently cancelled their tours to Japan for obvious reasons. But now, the last couple of weeks, a lot of people have started coming back, which is
okay.
Great. So thank you.
Oh, absolutely.
For giving us the sort of, you know, the vote of confidence. Obviously, here in Japan, you know, a lot of people need some healing at the moment, but you're about to go and volunteer up in Tohoku.
Yes, we are. My bandmates and I, as well as a couple of crew members, joined with an organization, and they have a project that's launching up in Ofunato, and we're heading up there to just sort of lend whatever support we can.
What are you expecting? What are you thinking?
I'm imagining it's going to be emotionally a pretty heavy experience. I don't know why I've felt so called to do this, but as soon as it happened, I knew we had Japan on our tour dates, and I made phone calls immediately and said, okay, I want to be a part of whatever sort of relief efforts are happening, and how can I do more than just a benefit concert?
It's been a real pleasure. Thanks for coming in on this fantastic sunny Wednesday afternoon. It's your day off. We'll let you go. Go and do your shopping. Go and eat more Japanese food.
Thank you so much.
It's been a real pleasure. Sarah Bareilles, thanks so much for coming in today.
Arigato gozaimasu. I'm so bummed that we never came here on my first record. I really, really wish that we would have spent time in Japan. didn't sleep that well. I think I'm nervous. Did you sleep okay?
I woke up at 6:30 wide awake.
Yeah. I kept waking up like every hour. Like,
so we are packing up, consolidating. There's not a lot of room on the train to take us up to Okinoto. So everybody's really only allowed to bring like a backpack. We are gonna grab our little satchels and head down to the train station and begin this journey. I was actually thinking about it in the train or in the car on the way here that I kind of wanted tissue. Isn't that amazing how the universe helps you out?
We're about to hop on the train and then a bus up to Ofunato. This is my life for the next 4 days. Sleeping bag, sleeping mat, and then just a Game Boy. Just buttloads of games.
And we have some juice, which I thought first was grapefruit, but I think it's orange. And after tasting it, I confirmed that it is orange juice. It's delicious.
Train's here. We're gonna hop on and see if we can find our seats.
That's home.
I'm going through the process in my mind. Would I ever be able to do this by myself? And the answer is no.
Seven people. Yeah, seven people.
1,500.
Yeah?
18,
yeah, right?
Need the third.
Need one more. We don't really know where we're going.
No.
Thank you.
I got to see. Got our tickets now. To get on the bus, it's gonna take us to Ofunato.
Super gorgeous landscape. You know, one train, one bus. Everything here in Japan is pretty tidy, pretty efficient.
It's a gorgeous day here, actually. This town is really peaceful. So I'm here with some of my bandmates and two of my crew members. Everybody has donated their time, and we are gonna try to make a difference.
There was over 800 kilometers of coastline affected with the tsunami. There's a tremendous amount of damage to homes, to infrastructure, to schools, to livelihoods. Our organization basically brings in volunteers after a natural disaster to help in the recovery process. Currently, our work in Japan is centered on Ofunato and Rikuzen Takata, two smaller communities in Iwate Prefecture. The work is primarily removing debris from people's homes and then gutting the people's homes so that they can take the steps that would put them back into their own home outside of the evacuation centers.
I don't really know what I just agreed to, but at this point I can't say no to the first thing asked of me. So I'm crawling into a very small space tomorrow, getting covered head to toe in mud, and digging it out into bags.
The feeling reminds me of like going to camp, you know, where you don't know anybody, you don't know what to expect, and you kind of, like, I don't really want to have expectations. And you know, I know as soon as you walk in the door, it's like, oh wow, it's really happening.
trim, the grass is nice, everything's picked up, everything's tidy. It's not even comprehensible that if you look at that, and 7 minutes earlier it's that. You spend your whole life knowing what that looks like, and then in 8 minutes, this is all gone. I'm just a basket
case. Oh!
It's been a huge project. The main two are these two apartment complexes, but we also, by word of mouth, got the house next door to go under the floors. But the main thing today is those apartment complexes. So I think if you guys just jump on wherever people around you will just get you right into whatever you're doing. Hard work, please.
Yeah,
absolutely.
We've actually gutted all the drywall. The last bits are the floorboards here that you're working on. And then from there, the absolute last thing is going underneath and just scooping up all the mud.
We just got in last night. Today's our first day of work. Everybody's kind of like split into little pairs, and some people are out, you know, in different groups and stuff. I don't know how many projects are going on right now, but everybody's just trying to get in where they fit in and work as hard as possible because we're here for such a limited amount of time. But we're stoked to be here and honestly humbled by the people around us and the task at hand, so.
Can I just give it a good kick? Go ahead. Yeah, baby. Ooh, it's quite satisfying. This is where you come to work out all your aggression, right?
Yeah, yeah. This wall has to come out too. This wall has to come out, it's wet. This wall has to come out. Okay. We're trying to move all the drywall up to a certain level, which would be a little bit above the scum lines, which you can see over here, so that they can be replaced by local Japanese repairmen. And underneath, you often find this is damp. You can't tell, but there's also mold growing on it. And this is 2 months after the tsunami, so it goes to prove what we're doing is the right thing, and it'll all get replaced and redone.
I am cleaning the floor of excess dirt and mud, screwing it off with this guy. You know, tall guy bending over a small broom.
Apparently the seawater came in from this angle, and water level you can see got up to, I think it got up to about here. So they cut down all the drywall and insulation about a foot above it, cut open the floor so you can get all the mold and all the mud, get it all dry, kill all the bacteria, and cart it all away, and then start over again from the skeleton. It's a lot of work. There's a lot of good people helping.
I'm just trying to clean up down here, scraping out muck. Scrub off all this shit first. I'm gonna clear up all this kind of settled rock stuff. And then bagging up all the muck. Making everything look as nice down here as it does up there. And getting educated on life. I don't know, I can't really complain about anything right now.
There's a pregnant daughter upstairs, so it's very important that we get any contaminants out of here so that they're not breathing it in.
I like this job.
2 months old, tsunami water still in the insulation. It's disgusting. We're making really good progress. At least everyone keeps telling me that.
I mean, there's a fish factory not far from here, and at other jobs in the area, we've found piles of dead fish that used to be like frozen.
Oh, gnarly.
Just the whole town just had this dead fish smell everywhere. It was really potent. I never really think about what got washed up in the tsunamis. Just trying to get whatever's here out.
There are very few things that are left, you know, but we just saw this for the first time, and it kind of reminds you that you're in somebody's house. This was somebody's home that came home to every day and, you know, had kids who made artwork, and now it's all gone. This kind of brings you back to thinking about that you're doing this for somebody else, you know, that these are actual families that are impacted. Day one's done. I feel good, my back hurts a little bit. And it's just starting to rain, so everybody's kind of ready to get back. We all want beer, desperately. But it feels really good to just spend the day working hard. It's good. Such a rad group of people. I got amazing stories and amazing just motivation for being here. Everyone really is coming from a good place and makes it really easy to like want to work hard. Clearing out these drainage ditches that align the street down here in this neighborhood that was in. The bay is sort of right that way, and the water brought in all the soil and gravel and rocks and pieces of people's stuff. They were finding all sorts of things. Water was basically as high as these buildings, just below that. So yeah, we're clearing these drainage ditches so things can start moving again. Making a big pile of debris that the big machines can come in. Today's a little harder than yesterday, I think, because we're seeing a lot more personal items. Yesterday we were just sort of clearing things from an empty apartment building, and today's a little more emotional. Since you went away, call me, call me, call me.
Incredibly nice and resourceful man, offering his tractor and his ability and his brains for a project, because these are very, very heavy. Very skilled with this. Look at this. So we can get the rope off.
Everybody, listen to the background. So three times a day in Ofunato, they test the tsunami warning system to make sure that the speakers are working. And they play music so people know that there's not anything to be afraid of. It's a little eerie because there's so many parts of the city that are still deserted. Apparently at 5 p.m. they play Let It Be by the Beatles. Ow! I can't leave till this is done. But we're gonna get a lunch break. Bento boxes, baby!
So close!
Right. It's been literally about 7 hours of just moving these cement blocks in and out. Oh, what do you think, about 50 pounds?
I think the smaller ones are 50 and the bigger ones are probably like 75.
75 to 100.
The bigger ones are for driveway entrance, I guess. I guess this was a driveway at some point.
Earlier today when we got here, been taking them out, and now we're putting them back after everyone's come through and cleaned all the dirt, mud. There's a lot of stuff from personal lives. Really anything that you can think of not the easiest thing in the world to get out, and now we're finding it's not the easiest thing to get it back. It's hard work, but hopefully the drainage system will be able to work more efficiently now.
There's all these really big, like, flat items, like pieces of tile and license plates. They kind of act like big dams. Can't get under them real easy. And they hold lots of on top. I got a shovel and some lower lumbar discomfort and a positive winning attitude.
This has been grueling today. And this particular section is hard because it's deeper and it's filled with big chunks of stuff, so shovels don't really go in there very well. I mean, we've done a lot. It's just oily and stinky and I need a shower.
Okay.
Okay.
So we got 10 seconds, buzzer. Here it goes. Oh yeah, that was good.
Okay, are we done?
We got it. Let's get some work done.
Let's go.
All right.
All hands volunteers, baby. I think dirt is our friend today. And it just rained, so it might be pretty muddy. But everyone just keeps going, oh, you're gonna get muddy. So I got my galoshes. And a good attitude, which I think is all you need. Day 3 of volunteer work. This is it. Home sweet home. They've changed our name from Canal Chaos to Ditch Bitches. We're going to be doing more of the same today, trying to finish this block and then probably move on to another one. And there's like 100. Lots to do. That work here at the community center invited us in earlier to have some coffee and water and tea and sit by the fire. It's a really beautiful gesture actually because, you know, we're definitely a group of dirty foreigners.
I grew up in Ofunato and I left the town when I was 15. After the earthquake, I came back. I started to work with all hands and I realized all hands are very good, excellent people. I have a very good time every day. Many local people getting to know the all hands and many of them are appreciating their effort.
Because we're on the ground in the community, we can hear what they say their need is.
Yeah.
And then we're small enough and agile enough that we can go, oh, okay, this is what you need. Let's see if we can do that. And then right. We move forward and we get to address the need quickly.
This is our last day. We're just about done. Got it all the way to the drain. This is like 1.5 blocks of many, but it feels satisfying to get something done. So. From woman got out, asked where we were from, and said thank you and gave us a call.
Oh, universal love.
I know.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that's pretty sweet.
That's really sweet.
It's really overwhelming.
There's crazy, crazy generosity. These people have nothing.
It's family. There's a young couple on there. Kid was in the back, and they drove up and
gave it to me.
That's awesome.
How are you guys feeling?
I think today it's been physically and emotionally draining, more than it has been the last 2 days.
Yeah.
It's all just gorgeous, but completely destroyed. It's really crazy to like shovel people's
personal
memories,
belongings, yeah.
You know, like pictures and little kids' shoes.
Yeah,
it's
today
hard.
Was loads of personal items. As I was crying on the stack of garbage on the corner, I was picking up kitchen stuff, like little dishes, and just thinking about like how cute those dishes would be in my kitchen. And then I thought they were probably really cute in somebody else's kitchen before they were in a fucking gutter somewhere. So these people have nothing, and it's really like as far as the eye can see, and this stretches down the coastline of Japan in both directions. It's pretty profound. Thank you guys for paying attention and listening to the needs of this very amazing, beautiful, incredible country. And like we said, go to hands.org. My website will also give you a lot of information, sarahbmusic.com. But yeah, all hands, all the time. Help out if you can. Japan needs your help.
Thanks, Sarah.
Yeah,
you're welcome. I appreciate Thank you. Your volunteering.
Absolutely. We're so grateful for the warm welcome in this amazing community that's doing such good work. I'm so grateful that you guys are here, and I've been so moved by the stories of each and every volunteer who chooses to either put aside a life that was going in another direction or make a right turn completely. It's so inspiring, and I'm so proud to have been a part of this, and I'm so grateful. So ignore me, I'm such a crier, I've always been.
Let it flow.
All hands, volunteers, unite for Japan.